Hello guys, I am Karthik Tiwari. Welcome to our geological zone. So today we will deal with the concept of oceanography. Oceanography is a subject applicable for the CSIR NEET. So oceanography. Today we will deal with the concept of oceanography. So ocean. We all know about the ocean and the graphy. Graphy means the analysis. We analyze the ocean and their zones known as oceanography. And oceanography is a subject applicable for the CSIR NEET, SAIL as well as GATE. Okay. So guys, today we will deal with the concept of oceanography. So oceanography is a branch of geology which deals with the study of or analysis of the oceans. So today we will deal with the concept of oceanic zones. For oceanic zones, we considered the picture of ocean. And ocean having the different zones. Zone 1, Zone 2, Zone 3, Zone 4, Zone 5. Okay, so the ocean having the different zones and that zones having the spatial names. Means all zones having the spatial names. Okay, in geology, the ocean bifurcate into the different zones. So vertically, ocean bifurcate into different zones. Like number 1, in between 0 meter to 200 meter. In between 0 meter to 200 meter, we call the epipelagic zone. So in between 0 meter to 200 meter, there is an epipelagic zone. Okay, and epipelagic zone is nothing but the sunrise zone. So we call the sunlight zone or the epipelagic zone. So epipelagic zone is also known as the sunlight zone. Behind that, 200 to 1000 meter. In between 200 to 1000 meter, there is a mesopelagic zone. So first one, epipelagic zone. After that, there is a mesopelagic zone. In between 200 meter to 1000 meter. Okay, the mean of meso means the intermediate. After that, in between 1000 meter to 4000 meter. There is a bathyal zone. So we call the bathypelagic zone for the bathyal zone. Okay. After that, in between 4000 meter to 6000 meter, there is a abyssal zone. First one, epipelagic zone in between 0 to 200 meter. The next one, mesopelagic zone in between 200 to 1000 meter. After that, bathyal zone in between 1000 to 4000 meter. And then, abyssal zone in between 4000 to 6000 meter. Then, 6000 to 10,000 meter. 6000 to 10,000 meter. There is a ocean basin. We call the ocean basin in between 6000 to 10,000. Then 10,000 to 11,000 meter, 10,000 to 11,000 meter, known as the hidden pelagic zone. We call the hidden pelagic zone. So, in ocean, there are different zones. Number one, the epipelagic zone. Number second, the mesopelagic zone. Number third, the bathyal zone. We call it the bathypelagic zone. or it's also known as the bathymelagic zone, abyssal zone, also known as the abyssopelagic zone, ocean basin, and hidden pelagic zone. Okay, the next naming for that means in between 200 meter to 1000 meter, in between 200 meter to 1000 meter, in between 200 meter to 1000 meter, we call the continental. The continental, then after that 200 to 1000 meter, in between 200 to 1000 meter, there is a continental shelf. Continental shelf, 1000 to 4000, 1000 meter to 4000 meter, known as the continental, the continental slope, 4000 to 6000 meter, 4000 to 6000 meter, we call the continental rise. Continental rise, and 6000 to 10000 known as the ocean basin. Ocean basin. So mesopelagic is similar to the continental shelf, bathymal zone is similar to the continental slope, and abyssopelagic is similar to the continental rise. Oceanic basin, oceanic basin, similar name for both figures. Okay, so picture one having the bifurcated oceanic zones, number one the epipelagic zone, number second the mesopelagic zone, number three the bathymal zone, abyssal zone, ocean basin, and hidden pelagic zone, and all zones having the different animals. Okay, means bathymal zone or abyssal zone, bathymal zone having the different number of fishes, and abyssal zone having the different classes like Echinodermata. Echinodermata act as a phylum. Okay, so different zones having the different classes or different animals. Okay, so oceanography, we analyze the ocean on the basis of different zones, and that zones applicable for the CSIR need, in between 0 to 200 meter, in between 200 to 1000 meter, in between 1000 to 4000 meter, in between 4000 to 6000 meter, in between 6000 to 10000, and 10000 to 11000. The numbers are important. The numbers are important for any entrance exam. Dekhiye guys, बहुत से स्टूडेंट्स ने कुछ लेक्चर्स देखने के बाद यही बोला था कि आप सर हिंदी में अगर ट्रांसलेट करते हो तो और काफी बढ़िया हो जाएगा हमारे सिटी के लिए. तो अगर हम इसी जोन को हिंदी में अगर बात करें तो बहुत ज्यादा इजी है. इट्स वेरी इजी इन हिंदी. अगर हम बात करें, अगर बहुत हमें ऐसा लगता है कि बहुत ज्यादा टिपिकल हो रहा है इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, तो ऐसा नहीं होता. हिंदी में भी हम उसे ट्रांसलेट कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो हिंदी में अगर बोला जाए तो सबसे पहले अगर हम जोन की बात करें, ओशियनिक जोन्स में डिफरेंट जोन्स होते हैं, ओशियन में डिफरेंट जोन्स होते हैं, और ओशियंस में डिफरेंट जोन्स जो होते हैं वो हम अगर जियोलॉजिकली अगर जाए तो मीटर में हम कंसिडर करते हैं. तो मीटर में अगर हम कंसिडर करेंगे तो जीरो से 200 मीटर तक अगर हम बात करें तो इपिपिलाजिक जोन रहेगा, 200 से 1000 तक अगर बात करें तो मेसोपिलाजिक जोन रहेगा, 1000 से 4000 तक अगर हम बात करें तो बथाइल जोन है, और 4000 से 6000 तक अगर हम बात करें तो अबिसाल जोन आपको मिलेगा. देन 6000 टू 10000 तक अगर हम बात करें तो आपको ओशियन बेसिन मिलेगा, और उसके बाद आपको हिडन पिलाजिक जोन मिलता है. और ये अलग अलग जोन्स में हमें अलग अलग एनिमल्स मिलते हैं. वैसे अगर हम कंसिडर करें तो दो ही जोन होते हैं, नंबर वन द ऑक्सीडेशन जोन एंड नंबर सेकंड द हाइड्रेशन जोन. ऑक्सीडेशन जोन में आपको ऑक्सीजन मिलेगा, हाइड्रेशन जोन में आपको हाइड्रोजन मिलेगा. लेकिन ये नंबर्स आपको बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं कि इसमें, क्योंकि इसमें बहुत ज्यादा क्वेश्चन होते हैं ओशियनोग्राफी पे. थैंक्स अ लॉट गाइज, प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड कमेंट. थैंक यू.